What? And who shut down that Texas legend and still sits next to us every day, gives us the lowdown on what really happened back then.
All this week, I'm going to separate fact from Broadway and Hollywood fiction. Let's start at the very beginning of the end of the most notorious bawdy house in Texas.
Don't touch that dial.
Texas has a whorehouse in Lord have mercy on us.
Action 13 received an anonymous complaint about two alleged houses of prostitution. The complainant said the houses were operating openly in our neighboring towns of Seeley and LaGrange. The LaGrange Chicken Ranch is gone, but the story is far from finished.
What an understatement I made 30 years ago. Yes, it's been 30 years since the infamous Chicken Ranch closed and found its way into Texas legend Broadway and the movies. Despite the Hollywood hoopla and Broadway ballyhoo, the best little whorehouse in Texas was not just a piddly, squat country place. There was plenty going on, illegal prostitution, criminal activities, and intelligent reports of organized crime. And here's the very first story of what we call the bawdy house.
Action 13 received an anonymous complaint about two alleged houses of prostitution. The complainant said the houses were operating openly in our neighboring towns of Seeley and LaGrange. It's illegal to operate a house of prostitution in Texas, and past history shows they cannot function without someone in authority protecting them. I ask Eyewitness News correspondent Larry Connors to check out the report.
Marvin, we started by getting a small van with curtains so we could conceal Eyewitness News photographer Frank Ambrose. Ambrose, a third person, and I went first to the Seeley location. What looks to be nothing more than an abandoned motel is a house of prostitution. We return later at midnight, but I can state as a fact that prostitutes are working here.
Then drove down County Gravel Road 130 and around the bend just outside LaGrange in Fayette County to the notorious Chicken Ranch, which had been operating for 129 years in flagrant violation of Texas law.
It's not so much into the house of prostitution which operates down here, but as to how long it has operated, why it has been able to operate so long, and who all is involved in keeping it operating. Ambrose stayed in the van as the third member of our party, and I went inside. I was carrying a small still camera in my coat pocket. I was getting what pictures I could inside while Ambrose filmed customers. Nearly three dozen came and went in a little over an hour. That's when we left and went back to the Seeley location. The next day, photographer Rick Armstrong and I returned to the LaGrange site.
Tomorrow, meet the real madam of the Chicken Ranch, Miss Edna Milton, and come face to face with the real sheriff himself, the late T.J. Flournoy. That as we look back at the 30-year anniversary of the Chicken Ranch, and remember...
Don't touch that dial!
Marvin Zindler, Eyewitness News.
Thank you, Marvin. Seems like only yesterday.
Tonight, the governor makes a decision no other Texas governor ever made. The governor closed down a house of prostitution once and for all.
It was the nicest little whorehouse you ever saw.
This report, compiled from the files of the Department of Public Safety Intelligence Division, revealed that local lawmen protected the bawdy house and that on two consecutive days, November the 17th and 18th, 1972, approximately 484 persons entered the Chicken Ranch. The report also stated that approximately $1.5 million a year was spent at the ranch.
That was a whole lot of money. Money allegedly for protection and payoff.
There are denials from all sides.
The late T.J. Flournoy, the sheriff of Fayette County, where the Chicken Ranch operated.
Sheriff, when you speak about that, they, of course, their figures and their information and so forth says that the money goes out of here into bigger organized crime, and that's where all the money's made. Now, who's right? You or the state?
Well, the state's a damn well, if that's what they say.
You don't think it's linked to any organized crime anywhere else?
I know damn well there's no organized crime connected in any way whatever.
Has your office or you or any of your deputies ever accepted any money from her or any way like that?
Not a penny. No, no payoff anywhere in the world to anybody.
Thanks, Larry. The wide open operations of these bawdy houses is hard to believe. So much that I went immediately to Austin to talk to Governor Dom Deluise.
I gave the governor the investigative reports from the Department of Public Safety.
First, I'm going to confer today with the Attorney General to determine what action his office should take and could take under the circumstances that you have presented.
The governor says he'll take action.
He's new in office and pledged to reform. We'll see. If he gets action on these bawdy houses, it'll be the first time ever.
Attorney General John Hill spoke out.
Our minds are fixed, our judgment is made, and we'll see that the law is enforced.
So it appears D-Day for the bawdy houses in Celia and LaGrange is Thursday.
Why has the chicken ranch operation been so long ignored?
We should be having some acoustic problems in here.
Aren't you afraid of possible payoffs and bribes?
Melvin? I'm sorry.
Colonel Spear, I'm sure, has advised you. And Sheriff Lenoid today advised the Department of Public Safety that in response to Colonel Spear's call of Monday, that the chicken ranch at LaGrange is permanently closed.
But the story isn't over. Tomorrow, meet the Texas government official who wanted the chicken ranch exposed, the man who got me into the act, the man who was closed-mouthed on the closing of the chicken ranch for decades. Remember...
Don't touch that dial.
Marvin Zindler, Eyewitness News.
Okay.
The Fayette County Sheriff took one final shock. And who was the target? Well, you guessed it. It was me.
Texas will always be known for its whorehouse.
Here's what's happening this Monday night. Action 13's Marvin Zindler and his cameraman were assaulted today in the streets of LaGrange by Fayette County Sheriff T. James Flanoy.
Sheriff, 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 somebody break, Marvin. Somebody break, Marvin.
He began immediately to yell obscenities at Marvin and began to punch Marvin. He grabbed him and was beating his head up against the car door in the window. I was sitting in the back seat. At that point, he grabbed his hairpiece, began waving the hairpiece around and threw it out in the middle of the street.
We settled out of court, and I donated the money to charity. What happened to all those folks that were involved in the chicken ranch? Well, former Governor Doc Briscoe is a retired rancher living in Uvalde. He and his wife donate hundreds of thousands of dollars to charity each year. Former State Attorney General John Hill is practicing law and chairman of the Texas Lottery Commission, which he's cleaned up. Former Fayette and Austin County District Attorney Oliver Kitzman went on to become a state judge and a fine family man. Former head of the Texas Department of Public Safety, which includes the Texas Ranger, Colonel Wilson Spear, went on to his final resting place. My colleague Larry Connors has been married over 20 years, has a family, and is a television anchor in St. Louis. The Chicken Ranch Madam Edna Milton, well, she got married, played in the Best Little Whorehouse in Texas on Broadway, and the last we heard, she moved to East Texas. Sheriff T.J. Flanoy has since passed away. The sheriff was a good lawman and never thought there was anything wrong in letting the chicken ranch operate. The chicken ranch itself, well, part of the house was moved to Dallas and became a fried chicken restaurant. That closed too, so what's new? And Marvin Zindler? Well, somebody's got to be around to tell the story. Who else would believe it? And there you have it, folks, the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, surrounding the legend of what's come to be known as the Best Little Whorehouse in Texas. And like most legends, it will outlive any of us who played a part in it. In fact, there's the Best Little Whorehouse in Texas playing in Texas City at the College of the Mainland through August the 10th. Marvin Zindler, Eyewitness News.